Well, I'm not really short Chipotle. I think it's a great time to short it, though. I'm actually looking at a $380 price. It might get there today, I don't know, but it hasn't gotten there recently. That's like the perfect price to short it at, and at that price, I think I'm going to do it. I think the price of Chipotle is remarkably high versus their earnings. It's a 40 PE for a company that has good products. I like their products. I go there.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not anti-Chipotle's products. But I think that they seem to be lines out the door and very saturated. And that means where's the growth going to come from? If you're pushing out maximum volume with lines out the door and you've expanded your store count to be almost ubiquitous, then where are you going to go from there? I have a hard time seeing why the PE is supposed to be 40 for a stock that's a company that's that more mature now than it used to be.
Apple corporate bonds. Any interest in those?
In Apple's corporate bonds?
Yeah.
Not really. They don't yield very much. They're super safe. I mean, Apple's a cash flow machine. You know, I kind of like Apple these days, just as a trade. I think it's formed a base. The PE, when you strip the cash out, is really pretty low. The PE on the business is 7 or lower, depending on what day you look at it. That's pretty low for now it's a mature business. They're having challenges with product innovation, but they're a cash flow machine. I think I'd rather own Apple stock than Apple bonds.
But it's a trade, not a long term.
Yeah, I don't like it long term. I think Apple stock may stay around 500, maybe some now and then it goes into the 300s, but it could stay there for years. It's kind of like the new Microsoft, you know, where the company is very big, lots of cash flow, but what's next?
Yeah.
And we don't know what's next for Apple.